Welcome back. So, I asked you guys for your favorite potato recipes and y'all came through. Literally, seeing the recipes, I wanted to make everything and eat everything. So, I just decided to eat potatoes for 24 hours straight. I know as an Indian, we love to put potatoes in every single dish, but potatoes in Maggi was completely unheard of for me and I really wanted to try it. So, for breakfast, I made potato Maggi by Soumya. To a hot pan, I added some sesame oil, finely sliced onions and green chilies. I let that cook until the onions were brown and caramelized. Then, I added one diced potato, seasoned with salt, pepper, garam masala, mixed it well and let it all combine and cook. To a separate pan, I added my Maggi noodles and masala and let that form into a no water, completely dry noodles. Around 10 minutes later, the potatoes had softened on the inside and were crispy on the outside. That is when I added my Maggi to it and combined. Believe it or not, this is it, potato Maggi, and obviously it would have been incomplete without some cheese on top. Now, coming to the flavor profile, was this a revolutionary change in the taste of Maggi? No, but as a person who likes to play with different textures of food, this did it for me. The onions were crunchy and the potatoes just added like 2 to 3 more layers to this thing and it was really good. I really liked it and I would definitely make this again. Mashed potatoes. Tell me one person who doesn't like mashed potatoes. I personally love them, but I rarely ever make them because, okay, dumb, but I don't like to boil potatoes. Anything that takes more than 5 minutes to boil, I just don't do it. But the times when my mom boils some potatoes to make whatever she's making, I steal a couple of them and make my one by mashing potatoes, adding butter, salt, pepper, and garlic powder. So, when Piera suggested making a cheesy roux, almost a bechamel, and adding that to my potatoes, I'm not even kidding, I am salivating right now and I had cheese pasta for lunch. I started by making a bechamel out of butter, flour, milk and cheese. For the seasoning, I used onion powder, garlic powder, piri piri masala, pepper and salt as she recommended. And oh my god, look at that. Look at that. It was stretchy and beautiful. I added that to the potato and mixed really well until the potatoes were fluffy. On a separate pan, I pan-fried some frozen veggies in some olive oil. I used yellow and red bell peppers, broccoli and corn, seasoned with simply salt and pepper. When this was done, I plated my potatoes and my veggies and topped with some Italian seasoning. Must be something that it features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. You see her walking down the boulevard. Imagine taking out the macaroni from mac and cheese and replacing those with potatoes. That is what this was. And I mean, I can see this becoming my comfort meal on days I don't feel like making anything else. Because this was so good. So good. Schlaskier by Alizia. I apologize in advance for butchering your name and these Polish dumplings. Okay, these are traditional dumplings made from potato and starch. She said she likes to have them with something sour and fresh, so I made a salad first by dicing an onion, some raw papaya, half a tomato and green bell pepper. Everyone's lining up to see it. There must be something that features. Find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. Let me paint a picture. I see they don't understand. Feeling like Picasso. For the dressing, I simply combined lemon juice, salt, and pepper. Meet the time of day. You be making moves that you who really care what Simon say. All the bad things, girl, I had to look. Mix it really well and then set aside while I made my dough. I started by smashing a couple of potatoes and added a half and half mixture of cornstarch and all-purpose flour. Just hold me down like that, yeah. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see it. There must be something that features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. She's a Mona Lisa. You probably don't know this, but I suck at kneading a dough. I always make a mess. I just don't know how to do it. It's not fun, but this was kind of fun. Like, a potato slime is fun. She's a Mona Lisa. I made balls from the dough and poked in the middle to make these shapes. To some boiling water, I added salt and my dumplings to boil. To top these dumplings, I melted some butter, fried garlic in it. Also added a little bit of oil to prevent the butter from burning, and then finally plated. I had 5 of these and they were so good. You know, sometimes you just combine the simplest of ingredients and it turns out to be so, so flavorful. Like, the simplest things can make something so good. Now the only consolation prize is maybe that the simulation got it right. And in that flash of light, I also wanted to make dessert, but I was just way too full for that. So this is it. A day of eating only your potato recipes for 24 hours. Bye!